there! Welcome to week 6. In this week, we will continue our survey of models for the estimation for the assessment of the probability of default of a counterparty. We will consider a model like credit metrics, which is an evolution, we could say, of Merton's model, but we will also consider other approaches, such as, for example, the approach of Credit Risk Plus. So, let's start with credit metrics.
Credit metrics was introduced in 1997 by JP Morgan, now JP Morgan Chase. It is a structural model of default, and it is worth noticing that it also takes into account the risk of credit deterioration. Do you remember the second component of credit risk? From a mathematical point of view, credit metrics can be seen as a Merton-like model.
The intuition behind credit metrics is rather simple. Instead of using liabilities as thresholds on which we define the default event, we will use credit ratings. We will define the thresholds for the model using credit ratings.
We consider a company that has been assigned to some credit rating class, say B, at the beginning of period 0, capital T. This means that for this company, we also have information about the transition probabilities to other rating classes and naturally about the probability of default by the end of the period. These transition probabilities can be computed using historical data or other techniques. Do you remember how to read a transition matrix like the one you see on your screen? If the answer is no, go back to week 4. With P bar J, we indicate the probability that our company will be in rating class J at time capital T. To simplify notation, we order the J's, so that J equal to 0 means default, and J equal to N means that our company is in the best rating class, for example, triple A. This implies that we consider N rating classes, including default. With P bar 0, we clearly denote the probability of default of the company at time capital T.
Using the same notation we used in Merton's model, with V capital T, we indicate the value of the assets of the company at time capital T. If you remember, under Merton's model, we have said that V capital T is linked to a normal distribution, and we have used the cumulative distribution function of a normal to compute the probability of default under Merton.
We can then define a set of threshold values D0 tilde, D1 tilde, Dn plus 1 tilde, such that D0 tilde is equal to minus infinity and Dn plus 1 tilde is equal to infinity. For all the other D's, we choose them so that the probability that V capital T is between Dj tilde and Dj plus 1 tilde is equal to P bar J. In this way, we translate the transition probabilities into a series of thresholds for the asset value of the company. By construction, D1 tilde is the default threshold. If V capital T is smaller than D1 tilde in capital T, our company defaults. All the other thresholds simply define the other rating classes, so that our company belongs to class J if V capital T is between Dj tilde and Dj plus 1 tilde. In credit metrics, in order to exploit the properties of the standard normal distribution, the asset value V capital T is transformed into a quantity X capital T using the formula you see on your screen. For a statistician, this is nothing more than a standardization. Naturally, we do the same for the threshold values. The consequence of this transformation is that now our company belongs to class J if X capital T is between DJ star and DJ plus 1 star. Let's consider an example to better understand the mechanism thanks to which we transform transition probabilities into thresholds for X capital T. Consider a B-rated company over a 1-year period and assume we have the following fictitious Moody's transition matrix. The probabilities we are interested in are those in the green row. Let X capital B be the rescaled asset value according to credit matrix of our B-rated company at the end of the year. According to data in the problem, we have that capital T is equal to 1. As anticipated, it can be shown that X capital B is distributed as a standard normal. Using the table, the probability that our B-rated company will improve its rating to AAA by the end of the year is 0.01% or 0.0001. For the AA class, we have 0.0004. If we consider the probability of default, this is 0.0473, and so on for all the other probabilities and classes. Using the quantile function of a standard Gaussian, we will now compute the threshold values we need for the credit matrix model. Let's start from the lowest rating class, that is default. The probability of default is 0.0473. This probability under the standard normal quantile function corresponds to a value of -1.6716. If X capital B is smaller than equal to -1.6716, we have that our B-rated company defaults by the end of the year. Notice that -1.6716 is simply the D1 star threshold. How can we compute the quantiles? Clearly with R, using the Q-norm function. If X capital B is bigger than -1.6716, but smaller than or equal to -1.6009, our company is in the CAC class. The value -1.6009 is computed using again the quantile function, but now notice that we have to cumulate probabilities. Starting from the lowest class, that is default, we also add the probability of moving to class CAC. Class CAA is then defined by threshold -1.6009 and -1.1790. This last value is again obtained by inverting the cumulative probability. Just look at the computation I did with Q-norm. Finally, the AAA class is reached if X capital B is larger than 3.7190, which is the 99.99% quantile. Notice that 99.99% is equal to 1 minus 0.0001, which is the probability for a B-rated company to enter the AAA class. Therefore, by ordering the rating classes, cumulating their transition probabilities, and applying the quantile function, we can compute all the thresholds we are interested in. And now, a question for you. What is the rating class at the end of the year of our B-rated company if X capital B is equal to 1.31? Naturally, the complete credit matrix model also takes into account dependence among defaults. This is done using probabilistic tools called copulas. In credit metrics, a Gaussian copula is typically used according to the so-called Lees model. But, as you can imagine, such a topic requires a knowledge of probability which I cannot assume in this course.
In R, there is a very nice package that you can use to play with credit metrics. It is called the credit metrics package. It's a rather complex package for the knowledge we have of R, but I'm posting the link to the package on the course platform so that if you want, you can play with it. So, for today, we are over. See you next time. Goodbye.